I consider watching Nell Cruz, and moving now to a musical segment, and we're joined with the opposite direction band, or Aksapari, and we are going to, first I'd like to introduce the band. We have Muhammad Mishu, a beatboxer, Muhammad Misti, rap singer, and Nishar Adib, rap singer, Huzaifa Al-Masri, vocal, and Ahmed, guitarist. We'll be moving now to the first song by Aksapari and Tani.
I hope you enjoy the song and the film. التعليم في مجتمعنا ملهوش اي معنى، في الكلية تجيب مقبول تلقى الفرحة مش بتسعنا، ملناش غير حل واحد هو اللي عليه اتفقنا، ذاكر وانجح باجتهاد تلقى القهوة بتجمعنا.
حاطط هدف قدامي بكون ملك زماني، ياخد ثلاث كورسات يفتحوا التعيينات وجه الدور عليا اقول انا ابن مين، قالوا لي مع السلامة يلا من غير مطروب، حرام على التعليم اللي ضيع سنين. يو ما احنا في بلدنا منسيين وانت في بلدنا مذكورين، بالوسط مدعيين وبالمصالح انتوا الخايفين واحنا خدامين. يو
التعليم في مجتمعنا ملهوش اي معنى، في الكليه تجيب مقبول تلقى الفرحه مش بتسعنا، ملناش غير حل واحد هو اللي عليه اتفقنا، ذاكر وانجح باجتهاد تلقى القهوه بتجمعنا.
الناس معقول ما تكلمش سمعت حاجات كتير، لكن ما بتتعلمش زي امشي بطريقك عدل يحصل عدل وكيل، مش يكون مستقيم من الحرش ما بتقدمش. يو فلو النجاح مفتاح انا مفتاحي كان مكسور، لان كتير فشلت واتركنت في الطابور، اتعلمت ان سر النجاح هو التعليم، دخلت واتخرجت وكنت من المضغوطين، حطيت قدامي اهداف لازم اوصل لها، ان اكون في بلدنا حاجه اشتغل واتعب لها، لكن بالتدريج بدات احلامي بتختفى وخلاص. الناس ملكني كانت تعليم ليا كلمت لا، عشان دورت في كل مكان بشهاده الامتياز، والرب كان واحد دايما وحاسبك راسك الازاز، لانه زي العادي مالكش شغل وده المعروف، بالوسط بس تشتغل ما تكونش على الرفوف.
التعليم في مجتمعنا ملهوش اي معنى، في الكليه تجيب مقبول تلقى الفرحه مش بتسعنا، ملقيناش غير معنى واحد هو اللي عليه اتفقنا، ذاكر باجتهاد تلقى القهوة بتجمعنا. التعليم في مجتمعنا يو
ابني وابنك وعجبني انك مش عارف تبني معاك، واللي ما contacted you viewers, and we have with us, we hope you've enjoyed the band with us. And now Prime Minister Ben Mahdi to the Monday the completion of the third development phase of the Egyptian Museum of the museum. The Egyptian Museum in Cairo contains the world's most extensive collection of pharaonic antiquities. No visit to Egypt is completed without the trip to the museum. The original collection was established in late 19th century and housed in Boulay. The objects were moved in 1991. In this respect, we have with us today engineer Ramez Azmi to highlight on the Prime Minister's visit for the renovation. Dr. Engineer Ramez Azmi is an architect and member of the Revival of the Egyptian Museum Initiative. We welcome you today on our show, Michael.
You're welcome.
And we have the pleasure to see you with us today.
Thank you very much
for joining us. And let's start first with the importance of the Egyptian Museum, and it has a lot of wealth in terms of the artifacts and also an impact on the economy too, because there's a lot of visitors who come specifically to the direction to visit the museum. So if you can speak to us a little bit about the museum in the first year.
You see, the Egyptian Museum is the icon of Tahrir Square, and the story of the Egyptian Museum is a long story. It began more than 100 years when Mr. Mariette, who was the chief of the antiquities, Egyptian antiquities, made a competition, architectural competition, to make a design for the new museum. And a very talented architect, French, Marcel Dornier, won this competition and made this beautiful building, which was a beautiful building in this time all over the world. And they collect all the treasures to keep it in the museum, especially the Tutankhamun collection, which is the most important treasures all over the world.
Yes.
And you see all over time, the original building gets some, it takes,
It takes time.
Yes. After this, we get this project to get it back to the original design.
Yes.
Because the original design is not appear anymore. You see, when we speak about the walls, they get about 8 layers over the original layer. So the colors and decoration and all the columns and the floor get another issue.
That's a huge project, because looking, to be frank, looking at the situation today with the Egyptian Museum, it hasn't changed since years.
Yes.
Nothing has changed. It's deteriorating. Looking at, even the boxes that is holding that is holding the artifacts, the storage, it is a lot.
It's a lot of changes, so we need to get it back to the original condition.
We have to mention to you that no tourist comes to Egypt that can trespass without visiting the Egyptian Museum, and it's a very important site in Egypt.
Because of
and
the
we have to make it worth this importance.
Yes.
And we have to work on it. And the revival of the Egyptian Museum Initiative was instigated in May 2012.
Yes.
Which aims to study the Egyptian Museum's existing conditions and develop a practical plan for its full rehabilitation. Who are the partners and sponsors of the initiative, Dr. Ramez?
You see a lot of foundations come with us to make this project, the EU and the European Union, and also the German government. And we have a lot of Egyptians who participate in this.
Who are those Egyptians that are participating in this?
Mr. Raif Ghabour.
Investors.
So it's good to be the Egyptians come back their heritage.
That's for sure.
Yes.
If you're looking at an example, for example, the Museum of Nuba,
yes.
In Aswan. And this is This is not a new museum, it's an old museum. Yet, if you look at the museum, look at the maintenance, how taking care, the technology behind it, it's really fascinating to see such an example. Yes. And I think it's one of the best examples.
Yes, of course.
What is making the museum all this time back away, in your opinion, from being another model like the Museum of Lib?
You see, we want to make this museum to be example for the other museums. But you see, it was designed by a way, so we want to keep it the way the architect designed from the first. Yes. So it's another.
You want to maintain the identity, you want to maintain the.
And to get the idea of the architect, because he made some colors and he made the symbols and decorations. So we get more than 200 sheets of handmade drawings that the architect made it. It is in the museum and it is a treasure.
So you're going to maintain every colors?
Yes.
The same. It's like, you know, putting it back to the original.
Yes.
Thing.
So you remove all the layers, you see, from the walls and from the floors. And to get back the original decoration, it's very, very, very beautiful.
But the floors is going to be a different story, because the floors, I think, you'll be having to granite or marble.
Marble for the ground floor.
Yes.
For the first floor, it was terrazzo. So we remove all the vinyl and get it back and polish it, and it's
so
very nice.
Does that mean that the museum will be, you know, certain places